And thank you so much for inviting me here and give me an opportunity to present what we're doing now. And my title is Action Plan Start Local Cooperation Asia. And we are appreciate your cooperation for the last almost 20 years. We have now developing integrated assessment model called AIM, Asia Pacific Integrated Model. We started to develop this model in 1990 with the fund of Ministry of Environment, Global Environment Research Fund. And after the first 3 years, we developed the basic model and started collaboration with the countries in Asia, and China, India, and Indonesia, and Korea. It was 1994. And we have, after the, from 1996, we have M International Workshop. So this year also, in February, we had a workshop, 16th workshop. And many of the researchers here also participated in this workshop. And we have used our models to assess policy policy issues. And the first model is focused on technology itself and how we can reduce CO2 emissions by the new technologies and what kind of technologies we should develop and deploy. But climate change issue is not only technology itself, but also we need to have the more broader scope, because the not only technology, but the way our lifestyle is also very much related to this to reduce emissions. So we started to the 2004 this low carbon society project. First we focused in Japan, and this for 5 years. This also funded by the Minister of Environment Japan. And from 2009, we extended this research, this low carbon study project to Asia. And now we are now doing this Asia low carbon society project. At the same time, we also participated in the low carbon society research network. And just now we started this JICA surface project with the collaboration here, Malaysia. And this is for us a very good opportunity to have the real application of our modeling. And we call M family model, and in this model, bottom-up technology model, and also macroeconomic model, top-down macroeconomic model, and energy snapshot model, and backyard model, and other element models. And we had also also M training workshop, and we transferred these models. And this year, we had training workshop on this macroeconomic model called CGE model. And as for the Japan Local Society Research Project, what we followed this process. First, we investigated how much level should greenhouse gas emissions should be reduced to keep the global target to the 2 degree target. And we estimated global emission to be reduced by half by 2050. And as for Japan, the target from 68%, it was the target in 2004. And now Japan government are focused on this 80% reduction. But at the time, we analyzed and we searched for the feasibility and show the visibility to reduce greenhouse gas emissions and show the pathways. And it's more important is to have a collaboration, international collaboration. And so we are Japan case, we have two different visions, development visions, vision A and vision B. One is technology-driven society, and one is natural-oriented society. And under these two visions, we develop scenarios and the action plans. And also using this MCG model, we analyze the industrial structure. And the industrial structure change from now if we want to achieve this low-carbon society to reduce deep cut in greenhouse gas emissions. And the industry move from secondary industry to third industry, and also even the secondary industry, some steel production is expected to reduce, but some electric and machines industry could increase. So it's a combination of such kind of the industrial structure change to achieve this low carbon society. And we are now have the innovative new materials coming and to be able to reduce to emissions. But we know there are some technologies and we know some way to reduce that, but we need to deploy technologies, or we need to restructure the industry structure. But, and for that, we need to invest. What kind of options is important? So in order to achieve reduction goal by 2050, we investigated which options should be selected, or when options should be introduced, or how much of each option should be introduced at each stage, with the reference of candidate options as prepared. So from the point of the modeling, we developed the Backcast model and applied Backcast model and prepared the key actions toward the low carbon society in Japan, and which actions can contribute to reduce emissions can be estimated by the modeling. And this information or the analytic result, to the policymakers, and they have the more ambitious reduction target, 80% reduction target now. And we need the funding mechanism very important, so we need early investment. But early investment can reduce cost and enhance energy efficiency of countermeasures in the long run. So if we have the long perspective, we can expect the reduction of cost by the energy saving, by using the energy saving technologies. And as for Japan, this is a 50% long-term target. As for the midterm target in Japan, we need to reduce emissions by 2020, 15 to 25% reduction in the domestic production. And in commercial and residential sector, it's increased the last several years, but from 2007 to 2009, and it's partly because of the Japanese economy and also partly because of the new technologies. This is some analysis, midterm target setting in Japan and 25% reduction in Japan. And we know there is so many technologies, but some technologies are very expensive and some technologies are cost-effective, and so we for each technology, we need different policy actions. For example, if the for technologies that are cost-effective, we have the enhancement of radar or mechanism to reduce paper period and visualization of counter-emergent activity. And the technology that is very expensive is mechanism also develop technologies and deployment. And also carbon pricing very effective policies to reduce. And it's very we need this one is the cumulative investment and estimate. And that, at the same time we can enjoy the reduction cost because of the energy saving. And in Japan, you know, we have now a very severe time. We have the tsunami and also the nuclear accident. And from the 1st of July, in the Kanto area, we have to reduce, the government forced us to reduce, and we also have to, we need to reduce in the 50% electricity consumption. And so many people are aware of the importance of the energy reduction, and also they are aware that if they reduce new technologies, lots of energy technologies are sold in Japan, and the people now are aware of the benefit of such kind of energy saving technologies. And for example, one local bank decided to have a loan with a zero rate loan, and to if the people buy the solar panel before the past 1 year, bank decided to have the zero. So such kind of many new mechanisms or new incentives now starting in Japan. And the investment, yes, the investment cost much, but we can also enjoy the benefit of the energy reduction in the long run. So this is the, we also have the studies in the local, not only the national government plan, but also the local government plan. And in Kyoto, they have the plan to reduce emissions 40% compared to 1990 level by 2030. And they have the, some action plans and 40 reduction by 2030 to 1990 level. They propose 6 action plans in Kyoto, and now they are doing, they are implementing such action plans. And as for the Asia Low Carbon Society study, Professor Zaltibor already mentioned about this path. This is the developed countries path. This is the target for low carbon world. And the path for the developing countries. So the developed countries path is here, but for the developing countries, if they follow this, they damage on the economy and natural system in the future, 2100 or 2200. now struggling to find the partners to this new, towards the local world. So why we are focusing on Asia? Yes, there are so many reasons, and of course, Asia has the economic development and the population is the also 50% of the world, and economic development is so rapidly, and also the greenhouse gas emissions also increasing rapidly. So we need to find some ways to avoid ruins in our infrastructure and energy systems in these Asian regions. And for that, we are now the main elements to be considering is energy and land resources and institutions and security and co-benefit. And if we think that there are so many co-benefits to reduce emissions, and if we count the social benefit, then the cost itself can be much lower. We can expect much lower than the if we account the other such kind of co-benefit. And so we are now working together with the Malaysia team, also Indonesia, Vietnam, Thailand, India, China, and Cambodia. So we developed this first version of the action plans and leadership plans. And so now is a stage to work together with the policymakers to implement such kind of the action plans. So last January, we visited Professor Bose of UTM and also Putrajaya and Iskandar Regional Development Authority. And we had a good discussion, and now I'm very happy to be here and to meet again. And also we had the training workshop in November last year in Thailand, and we studied the simulation scenarios and the sustainable carbon society policy implementation using AIM. So such kind of network are now I think is increasing. But still, it's very, very difficult task to achieve this local, follow this local society pathways. We can draw these pathways, but to achieve this, still there are so many barriers. So there are no common general policies. So we need to find in each country, country by country, these new policies to achieve local society. And the success depends on the participation of local government and people. And so the stakeholders' involvement is very important, but in small regions and cities, there's still little awareness. And so we need to involve those people to realize this local society, and capacity building is slow and time-taking, but we are now doing such kind of this capacity building workshops through workshops. And the good quality infrastructure services almost always necessary, and we will see that the development priority local society is difficult to be achieved, and in this Asia here, there are so many developing other priorities to overcome the poverty or to access to the good quality of water, and such kind of these developing goals should be we need to have a synergy with such kind of development goals. And investment has to be more in innovation or need strong message for policymakers. To overcome such kind of barriers, we think that this local society could be achieved. And now we are working together with the many agile kind of researchers. And we had the workshop in February and the training workshop in July. And through such kind of the workshop and also we have also the with the cooperation the local society research network, we have also the workshop in Cambodia or Vietnam and Indonesia. So now such kind of movement is extending, and I hope we will have the good result through this international collaboration. Thank you very much for your attention.